Chicago Bears off a very successful season last year with a new coach. They have a young quarterback who's on a very team-friendly deal, a top three, actually top two pick because of a trade that happened on draft day. A lot of excited Bears fans because Mitch Trubisky has that potential, right? Could he grow? Could he become a top-tier quarterback? As we often see with teams that are picking at the top of the draft, a rebuilding of the team is in order. That certainly happened with the Bears, and they've been successful. But what can we say about Trubisky specifically at this point?
Well, that's the really hard part because it confounds a lot of situations. The Bears have done a great job. They built a great defense. A lot of those players were under John Fox, but some of them came in, namely Khalil Mack, under Matt Nagy. And then that offense, they got Allen Robinson a season ago, Tariq Cohen, you know, elevated after a good rookie season into a great player, top five running back last year. So then the question is, and the one that PFF is uniquely suited to answer is, how much of this was contributed by Mitch Trubisky? Was it a good offensive line, you know, a top 10 pressure rate against last season? Was it a great coach, a top 10 coach last year? Was it a defense that sort of kept him in every single game? He never had more than a 14-point deficit against, and those were pretty fleeting last year. So was it the situation that gave Mitch Trubisky a chance to look good, or was it Mitch Trubisky actually playing well last year?
And there were certainly times where he did play well in games, in parts of games. He flashed some incredible ability. The key is to not get too, you know, swooned by the really nice plays and to look at the entire corpus of work on its, you know, in its full and its entirety, and from that to make decisions. So when we look at Mitch Trubisky, there are a couple of things that stick out to me and that stick out from a numbers perspective, which maybe we should pump the brakes a little bit. The biggest is when we think about the most stable characteristics of quarterbacks, what are the things that you can hang your hat on and say, this is going to be something that this quarterback continues from season to season? The two are play from a clean pocket. What does a quarterback do when he's got a nice environment around him? And how well does he avoid making negatively graded throws? Or another way to think about that is, how does he avoid making those uncatchable passes where the receiver just doesn't have a chance? And Mitch Trubisky was bottom five in all of those metrics. So there is there's some reason to pump the brakes here. It's just not something that you see from guys that are in the top 10.
Well, and we saw the manifestation of it, right? Against Minnesota, he had some pretty bad interceptions, but that defense played so well that they weren't backbreakers for his team. And so when the opportunity came for him to make some good plays, for him to give that team the lead, they were still there. If your defense goes down a little bit, maybe from first in the league to fifth or first in the league to 10th, that interception might be when you're already behind 7 points, and it puts you in a precarious position the rest of the game, and quarterbacks playing from behind have more difficult circumstances, et cetera, et cetera. So when we look at Trubisky, oftentimes we didn't see the biggest negative ramifications for him being, you know, poor in terms of generating negatively graded throws, being poor, even catchable and accurate passes, passes that were caught by his teammates, but not the most accurate. He was 31st last year in avoiding those as well. So, you know, if those were to happen again this season, if he doesn't have a fundamental shift in how good he is, like, you know, variance might hit the Bears and hit him strongly.
And that receiving core did a tremendous job. They caught a much higher rate of passes than the NFL average. They were a top five unit in that respect. So he definitely was helped out by that. You still have that system. You still have those receivers. It just will take them playing at another very high level. I should mention, Mitch Trubisky does a nice job of running with the football. And we've seen quarterbacks, Cam Newton is one of them, who isn't the most accurate, but he makes up for it in a lot of ways because of what he can do running the football. Does Mitch fall into that category for you?
I mean, I don't think so necessarily, because they don't design runs for him the way they do for Newton. And we've seen with Newton, like, when all of the cards fall well, right, he can be the MVP, he can take a team to the Super Bowl. Whenever anything goes wrong, last season was a shoulder injury. We've seen times when his supporting cast wasn't particularly good, or his coaching staff wasn't particularly good. The wheels fall off, right? And so with Trubisky, I think, you know, they're going to be a little shy away from running him design runs next year because of the injury he had, missing two games in the middle of the season. And again, like, the situation was pretty perfect for him last year. If it perturbs from that at all, like, we're going to probably see some of the wheels falling off of the Bears offense.
There has never been a quarterback, I say this all the time, I think this really hits the point home. Yep. There's never been a quarterback who's been in the top five in rate of negatively graded throws to then lead a top 10 offense the following season. It just does not happen.
Yep.
Closest anyone's come is Deshaun Watson, who was 11th the 11th best offense a year after being top five in negatively graded throws. I got that out, finally. But here's the thing. Everyone wants to talk about, look, someone that was bad can improve.
Yep.
Yes, absolutely. And I think both of us are hoping that that is the case because it will be better for the NFL. But every single quarterback is trying to improve. That is what every quarterback's job is to do. So we shouldn't be making having huge expectations for someone just because the team overall had a good season.
Yeah, for Trubisky to meet most Bears fans' expectations, not only is he going to have to improve, but the luck component, the variance component, is going to have to remain constant or improve next season. And that just simply is not, like, that's not in the cards oftentimes. So we might see a situation where Trubisky is truly a better player, grades better from a PFF perspective, and we just don't see as good of an outcome. And that's going to be, I think, if you're a Bears fan, encouraging, if not a little bit annoying, you know, for in 2019.
Well, that's my bet. I think there's no way he plays worse than he did last year, but the results just simply won't be as good. Very Deshaun Watson-esque, if you will. For more, head to profootballfocus.com. And if you're angry about any of this, I don't know why you would be, PFF_Eric will take all of your hate.